How are you? I hope that you will be fine. I am Aditi Vikram Rai from Alpham Public School, and this school is situated in Golam Bazar. And now that your topic is more on MS Paint, that is chapter 5, and we have learned last day the paint window, pencil tool, eraser tool, fill with color tool, color picker tool, text tool, brushes tool, and to our today's topic is drawing shapes, and subtopics polygon tool, curve tool. We have to learn this topic, drawing shapes, and there are two subtopics in drawing shapes, that are polygon tool and a curve tool. We have to learn this topic on today, and now we have to start. We have learned the paint window. You know that we have revised one time. The paint window has two main parts: ribbon and drawing area. Ribbon contains the tools that you draw with, and drawing area, it is the area where you draw. Ribbon is divided into two sections: tabs and groups. Tabs, in the paint window there are two tabs: room and view. These tabs contain different commands to draw and edit the picture. Groups. A group is a collection of related commands. For example, clipboard, image, tools, shapes, and so on are some groups on the home tab. Next one is our topic, pencil tool. The pencil tool is used for freehand drawing. It gives you the feel of drawing on a sheet of paper. To use the pencil tool, follow these steps. In first step, in the tools group, select the pencil tool. In second step, in the colors group, choose any color in the color palette. Make sure that a color 1 button is selected. Third, click on the size drop down button, select a thickness option for the pencil line. In fourth step, in the drawing area, left click and drag the mouse to draw a tree with leaves and trunk. Eraser tool. To erase any part of a drawing, you can use the eraser tool. To use the eraser tool, you have to follow some steps that are given. Select the eraser tool in the tools group. Move the pointer onto the drawing area. The pointer shape changes to a square. Now click and drag the pointer over the area you wish to erase. Now that's next topic is fill with color tool. The fill with color tool lets you fill color in any closed shape or area in your drawing. To use the fill with color tool, follow these steps that are given. In first step, you have to draw a closed shape or drawing. Select the fill with color tool in the tools group. Second, in the colors group, select the color 1 button. Then select any color in color palette. And third, move the pointer on the drawing area. Click inside the shape, the chosen color fills inside the shape. And the next topic is color picker tool. The color picker tool is used to pick a color from the picture and fill exactly the same color in another area or object. To use the color picker tool, you have to follow some steps that are given here. Draw one more balloon in your drawing. In the tools group, select the color picker tool. Third, bring the pointer to the drawing area. The shape of pointer changes to a dropper. Fourth, click on the outline of the yellow balloon, as example red. The color picker tool picks the red color. Notice the pointer changes to a fill with color tool. Move the pointer to the new balloon and click anywhere inside it. The same color fills inside the balloon. And next, our is text tool. A text tool is used to enter text in a drawing. If you want to enter text in a drawing, then you should have used text tool. To use the text tool, you have to follow some steps that are given. Firstly, you have to select the text tool in the tools group. First step, select the text tool in the tools group. Second step, select any color in the color palette for the text. Make sure that a color 1 button is selected or not in the colors group. Third, bring the pointer to the drawing area. Fourth, click and drag the pointer on the drawing area where you wish to enter the text. A dotted rectangular box appears with a blinking cursor inside it. The text tab appears on the ribbon. Using this tab, you can change the text size, color, and style. Now, on fifth, there is type the text you want. And on last step, you have to enter the text that you should want. Info box, once the text in fourth step, you have to click and drag the pointer on the drawing area where you wish to enter the text. A dotted rectangular box appears with a blinking cursor inside it. The text tab appears on the ribbon. Using this tab, you can change the text size, color, and style. And in last step, you have to type the text you want. And info box, once the text is entered, it can't be changed. You can make changes only when the text is inside the dotted box. That means if you entered one time text, then you can't change it. You can make changes only when the text is inside the rectangular box. Okay, now that's your next topic is brushes tool. We have to learn this topic today. That is brushes tool. The brushes tool works like a paintbrush. And you know that the brushes tool works like a paintbrush. As like paintbrush, the brushes tool works. That is given in the book. Paint has different types of brushes. And you know that also paint has different types of brushes that give artistic effect to the drawing. To use the brushes tool, you have to follow these steps. Firstly, you have to click on the brushes tool and drop down arrow. In second step, you have to select the brush you want to use. Third, choose the thickness of the brush from the size drop down list. Fourth, in colors group, select color 1 button. Select any color in the color palette. Fifth, move the pointer onto the drawing area. Now drag the mouse to draw. Once again, you have to want brushes tool. The brushes tool works like a paint brush. Paint has different types of brushes that give artistic effect to the drawing. To use the brushes tool, follow these steps. Firstly, you have to click on the brushes tool, drop down arrow. Second, select the brush you want to use. Third, choose the thickness of the brush from the size drop-down list. Fourth, in colors group, select color 1 button. Select any color in the color palette. Move the pointer onto the drawing area. Now drag the mouse to draw. Now, our today's topic is, that is, drawing shapes. You know that there are many types of shapes. That's like rectangle, cube, cuboid, square, triangle, and many shapes are here. The shapes group has various tools to draw shapes. If you want to draw shapes in your drawing that you should use, then you have various tools to draw shapes. The shapes group has various tools to draw shapes. There are various tools in shapes group to draw shapes like triangle, oval, rectangle, star, and many more. Let us learn how to use polygon tool and curve tool. Polygon means there are many sides in polygon. A rectangle, a triangle can be said to be polygon. Now, how to use polygon and curve tool. Now come on polygon tool, that your first topic is polygon tool. The polygon tool is used to make a custom shape with any numbers of side to draw a polygon. The polygon tool is used to make a custom shape with any numbers of side to draw a polygon. If you want to draw a polygon that you have, polygon tool is used to make a custom shape with any number of sides. To draw a polygon, you have to follow some steps. Firstly, you have to click on the home tab. After that, you have to select a polygon tool in the shapes group. In third step, you have to choose any color in the color palette. Make sure that color 1 button is selected or not in colors group. Note, color 1 option decide the colors of the shape outline. Fourth, click on the size button in the drop down list. Select the thickness of the outline. In fifth step, bring the pointer onto the drawing area. Drag the pointer to draw a line. Click at the desired point to add a new side. 6. After drawing the first line, you do not have to drag the pointer to draw a new line. Simply click at a point where you wish the new side to be appear. A new line joins from the last point. This way you can add multiple sides to your shape. Drawing shapes. The shapes group has various tools to draw shapes like triangle, oval, rectangle, star and many more. Let us learn how to use polygon tool and curve tool. Polygon tool. The polygon tool is used to make a custom shape with any numbers of side. To draw a polygon, you have to click on the home tab first. In second step, you have to select the polygon tool in the shapes group. In third step, choose any color in the color palette. Make sure that a color 1 option is selected in the colors group. In fourth step, you have to click on the size button in the drop down list. Select the thickness of the outline. And you should notice color 1 option decide the colors of the shape outline. Fifth, bring the pointer onto the drawing area. Drag the pointer to draw a line. Click at desired point to add a new side. 6. After drawing the first line, you do not have to drag the pointer to draw a new line. Simply click at a point where you wish the new side to appear. A new line joins from the last point. This way you can add multiple sides to your shape. Note, the polygon shape is complete only when you connect the last point to the first point. Now that's your next topic is curve tool. Let's learn what is curve tool. The curve tool allows you to draw curve line. If you want to draw curve line, then you should use curve tool. The curve tool allows you to draw curve line. That means curve tool allows you to draw curve line. To draw a curve line, you have to select the curve tool in the shapes group. On second, click on the color 1 button in the colors group, then select a color in the color palette, and from the size drop down list, select the thickness of the line. In fourth step, you have to bring the pointer to the drawing area, press the left button and drag the mouse to draw a line, release the mouse button, and in fifth, click anywhere on the line and drag the mouse to get a curve. Once again, curve tool. The curve tool allows you to draw curve line. If you want to draw curve line, then you should use curve tool. Curve tool allows you to draw curve lines. To draw a curve line, you have some steps that are given. You have to follow some these steps. On first step, you have to select the curve tool in the shapes group. From shapes group, you have to select firstly curve tool. On second, click on color 1 button in the colors group. From colors group, you have to click on color 1 button. Then select a color in the color palette. From color palette, you have to select a color. In third step, from the size drop down list, select the thickness of the line. You have to select the thickness of the line from the size drop down list. That is step third. And after fourth, bring the pointer to the drawing area, press the left mouse button and drag the mouse to draw a line. And after that, you have to bring the pointer to the drawing area and now press the left mouse button and drag the mouse to draw a line. And after that, you should release the mouse button. In fifth step, you have click anywhere on the line and drag the mouse to get a curve. Okay, so you have to read this topic, drawing shapes, polygon tool and curve tool. And also you will learn chapter 2, because chapter 1 is given on last day. For learning, then you have to learn chapter 2, all exercises given in book. Thank you.